and I are to seek after. It is not just simply delivered into our hands without any participation on our part. It is almost like when you buy one of your kids a bicycle for Christmas, and the wife says to you, you know, you need to put that thing together before Christmas Eve. Remember, we got that Christmas Eve service. We don't even get home till midnight. No problem. You put it off. You wait. You come to Christmas Eve service. You get home at a little bit after midnight. You open the box and you find out that it takes someone with a master's degree in engineering to be able to put the bike together. And you are up till 3-4 in the morning, so mad, so frustrated, you don't know what to do. Reminds me back when in my seminary days, and I can't remember exactly who it was that gave the gift. I'm sure my wife did. I don't think it was us. I think it was one of his granddaddies. But Justin was like 2.5 years old. And Christmas came along, and they would always come out the day or 2 days after Christmas. And so they were out with us. And actually, they had come early that year. It must have been because it was Christmas Day. It was Christmas Day. We're opening this box. He got a red wagon for Christmas. Red wagons are not that complicated. They really are not. His two grandchildren. nuances of difference. But basically, what the Old Testament calls the fear of the Lord, the New Testament calls the faith that we all have. The faith. So what is that? It is understanding who God is, understanding who I am, and understanding God's gracious gift of salvation for me. It's like when we first are awakened to the knowledge of God. And I'm not talking about what we learned growing up in Sunday school and vacation Bible school. I'm talking at that moment when the Holy Spirit moves on us and we respond to God in salvation. What is it that happens first? Almost always, not all the time, but almost always, there is this overwhelming feeling of our guilt before a holy and righteous God. That we are totally helpless before Him. That we are totally undone before Him. That we stand in His judgment. And at that moment that we have that foreboding feeling of the weight of our sins, we see the cross and we recognize the gracious love of God that frees us from that fear of judgment. What we call faith. We reach out to this gracious God knowing we deserve judgment and instead receive His grace and His love and His mercy and His forgiveness. That is the fear of the Lord. The belief in the gospel. It is the very beginning of all accurate wisdom and knowledge. Now, certainly, we could go further and say, well, you know, I've always heard that the fear of the Lord is a reverence that we are to offer to God. And that is absolutely true. But what is reverence except the recognition of the faith? It all goes back to what the New Testament calls faith. My standing with God based upon God's law condemns me, but the cross of Jesus Christ saves me. What is it the New Testament says? The love of God, the perfect, perfected, righteous love of God casts out all fear. I no longer have to fear the judgment of God. I now live my life by faith in what Jesus Christ has done. Lots of us make a decision for Christ, and I'm not questioning our salvation. But you know, maybe you've been one of these people. I think lots of us have at some point. But you meet people all the time who have prayed to receive Christ. They have made profession of faith in Christ Jesus. And perhaps they are really growing in the Lord, trying to live for the Lord. And yet, there is this judgment they are so overwhelmed by the judgment aspect that they are not set free by the grace aspect. And it's like they're living their lives under the judgment when they're supposed to be living their life under the grace. can solemnly claim that the wisdom of God is our gift to unwrap and put together and apply is contained within the cover of this book. And it begins with faith. Let's pray. Lord God, we just come to you tonight. We thank you so much.